Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, John Richardson, Sean Locke, Sarah Millican, Humphrey Carr, Rich Hall, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy
to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, one of the oldest winners of Countdown was 82-year-old Mary Gordon? Until the 17th century, there was no clear distinction between the letters I and J. That's a great fact to drop into conversation on a date if you don't want the date to end with a girl touching your winkle. Americans call mathematics math because they argue mathematics functions as a singular noun, so math should be singular too. Fair enough, Americans, but by the same singular rule, you're a bunch of arsehole. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up is John Richardson. It's John's 10th anniversary as a comedian, so what better way to celebrate than by getting you a... drum roll, please. We got you a drum roll. Hope you liked it. John has a new girlfriend. She's everything he could have ever imagined. She's imaginary.
Know so much about me. I haven't told anyone it's 10 years since I started doing comedy. I've told everyone I've got a girlfriend, I'm not going to lie to you.
Well, 10 years since we Googled you.
Does it say on there, does it?
Well, it says when you started doing comedy and we worked out, we got Rachel to help us with the maths. 10 years.
Wow.
Happy anniversary.
Thanks, mate.
And on John's team tonight, it's Sarah Millican. Millican is the nation's best-selling female comedian, which is no mean feat considering we've got Lily Savage, Dame Edna and that one-off Mrs Brown's boys.
I've got a better beard than any of them, though.
I imagine Sarah's very excited to be on Countdown tonight. Normally, the only letters Geordies get are the ones from bailiffs.
Be very careful. I
okay.
know people.
I don't.
You don't know anyone?
Nah.
Not at all.
Not really deep down.
Oh.
People put up barriers when I'm around.
Like physical, actual, like, barriers?
Sometimes.
Yeah. I'm a bit uncomfortable being this close
this
to you,
This is close,
to be honest.
Isn't it?
It is.
Look.
Ooh!
OK, up against them this evening, it's Sean Locke! Sean is currently on a lengthy nationwide tour. He's delighted, as is his wife. And on Sean's team tonight, it's Humphrey Carr. Humphrey Carr went to Eton and paints toy soldiers in his spare time. The only thing posher and wetter than him is the Princess Diana Memorial Fountain. That's fine, that fountain is wet and posh. What do you want? It sounded worse than it was.
It did. I think just any mention of Princess Diana and you in the same sphere.
Hey, those are just rumours.
Yeah.
It'd be good if we get a nine-letter word tonight in his underpass. To really, you know, complete the circle.
Here's hoping. You spell your surname, it's Carr, but it's K-E-R.
That's, yeah, that's correct.
No, it isn't.
What?
This is my point, it's C-A-double. I mean, good luck on Countdown if you can't spell your own name.
I mean, C-A-double-R isn't right, is it? While we're being dickheads about it. Carr is... Carr is K-A-R-R.
Carr. It's K-A-R-R. So, John, have you got a mascot? You got anything this week?
Well, no, I brought something to up my game. So, this is a reminder to me. This is my basic certificate in food hygiene. It's a genuine qualification. John J. Richardson has successfully completed a programme of training and assessment, so I took this down off my wall today, out of its gilt frame.
You took it off the caravan with which you sell burgers by the side of the road.
Now, Sarah, do you watch the show? Do you watch Countdown?
Yes, I do. And I am much better at it now that you can pause the telly.
Are you looking forward to playing with John? I mean, he's a pretty good team leader, I think. In terms
is he a leader? I thought we were just a team.
Qualifications.
And have you got a mascot? Have you got any?
Yes, I have.
What have you got?
I've got a doll of myself that someone made me. And I thought then I believe in myself, so I should have a mascot of myself.
She's
not very well today. She's having a lie down.
Let's spare the audience a little bit, shall we? In case it's very realistic.
Hold it up. There we go.
Sean, you won last week. You beat John.
Mm.
How's it feel?
Not as good as I thought. I did the thing that I always do when I win Countdown, which is I have a bath in alphabetti spaghetti. And I thought I'd drive myself off, but when I bent over and caught a glimpse, I had a 9-letter word in the crack of my arse. And it was underpass. It wasn't just like all the differently arranged, it was underpass, stuck very carefully, because I've got I've got one buttock that's pronounced prouder than the other. I think it was I used to ride pillion a lot. Anyway, so they're all arranged on one buttock, and I caught it in the mat, and it said underpass. It's very rare in a tin of alphabetti spaghetti to get two S's. That's what really freaked me out.
It's not much of a bath in alphabetti spaghetti if you only use one tin, is it?
Have you got a mascot this evening?
Yeah, I do. It's this. It's Phonesy. This is Phonesy.
Phonesy?
Yeah. And I find when I'm playing the game, that bloody clock really spoils it.
The Countdown clock, you're saying, spoils.
Yeah,
Countdown.
Because you're trying to think of words, but you put these on. You've got to come over and tell me when the clock's finished, which buys me extra time. They buy me some extra time. Didn't you hear me?
I haven't got them on. Yeah, I heard you.
Pardon?
Humphrey, could you take those off him?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh. Lovely. Okay, Humphrey, have you seen the show?
Have I? Yes.
Are you good at this?
No.
Are you better on numbers, the letters? Well, what do you think?
I use letters more often. All the time.
Don't posh people refer to themselves as one, though?
Yeah, unfortunately, no one referred to themselves as 150, which is the biggest of the big numbers.
Yeah, why is the biggest of the big numbers?
100.
Oh, shit.
It's good to know. Over in Dictionary Corner, it's Rich Hall, everyone. Rich Hall is American. They do a version of Countdown in America, but with its difficult word games and challenging number puzzles, it had to be dumbed down. Over there, it's called Sesame Street.
It's two now. Been two insults directed at this one.
Very nice to have you. Have you seen the show before, Rich?
No.
Is there any equivalent in America? Do you have anything?
There's Hawaii 5-0.
With you, in Dictionary Corner, we've got, of course, Susie Dent. Give Susie Dent a round of applause. Susie worked as an English language teacher in the US after leaving university. An English language teacher in the US. Imagine that's like being a health and safety officer in Helmand Province. Okay, and in charge of the numbers is Rachel Riley. Rachel is also a presenter on Channel 5's The Gadget Show, which I was disappointed to find was just her testing headphones and stuff. Any tips for the contestants this evening?
Well, based on the last few attempts, it's just very important that the words are real ones.
OK, well, tonight our teams will be competing for this, the Countdown Teapot. How do you know to do that? okay, let's count down, everyone.
Yeah.
Time for our first game. John and Sarah, you're to pick the letters.
I'll let you pick these, but if we get a Y and an I, we haven't finished. That's not a word.
Totally is. Shut your face. Can I have a vowel, please?
You can, thank you. Start with A.
Another vowel, please.
O.
A consonant, please.
H.
Another consonant.
R.
And another, please.
T.
A vowel, please.
U.
I'm done.
Sick.
Another vowel, please. And
E.
Thank you. And two more consonants, please.
And V. And the last one, G.
OK, everyone, let's count down.
Sean, what have you got?
Five.
Doesn't last as long as you'd like. Sean, you got five. Humphrey, what you got?
Six.
OK. John?
I've only got five.
Sarah, what you got?
I've got 12. Three fours. Yeah, but they're all really good.
All right, let's go with your fours first.
I've got goth, goat, and H-O-T-A, hotter.
It's a Geordie thing.
Can you use that in a sentence?
I was cold before, but now I'm hotter.
What? Now, John, you got a five?
I got hover.
Sean, what have you got?
I've got a few fives. I've got avert, trove, vague.
OK. Humphrey?
I made a mistake.
You made a mistake?
I made a mistake.
OK, what have you got?
Well, if there was a C... which there is on my piece of paper, because I wrote it down because I misheard what the letters were, you could have had grouch.
Yeah! You could have had loads of words if there'd been other letters there.
Other than my six, I also got cargo. Oh! That also has a C in it.
I mean, I do appreciate, Humphrey, your height advantage you're bringing to the team. But apart from that...
OK, so it's 5 points to each of you. But, Rich, could they have done any better?
Yes, they could have. They could have done author V. If you had five Roman writers, the fifth one would be author V.
That's an excellent point, Rich, yes. Susie?
Just sevens. They send tougher and outrage there for seven.
OK, on to our first numbers round. Sean and Humphrey, your turn to pick the numbers.
Well, I had two from the top and then the rest. I can't remember how many numbers you're supposed to pick. Six, is it?
Six, yeah. You can have four little ones. Two large, four little. And they are 8, 9, 3, 8, and the large 2, 50 and 75. And the target, 979.
Okay, let's count down. It's worth mentioning, Humphrey, there is no C up there. What have you got, Sean?
I've got an incredible 979,658.
OK, Humphrey, what have you got?
I might have 979.
Yeah?
OK.
Yeah.
O
Don't bother with that.
Let's wait and see, shall we? OK, John, what have you got?
I think I've got 980.
Ooh. OK. Sarah?
I've got nowhere near, cos this is a bit where I'd normally pause it and have about 20 minutes. And a calculator.
Yeah, the actual 30 seconds is a pain, isn't it?
It's faster than I thought.
Here, isn't it?
It's really loud.
And when you watch the show, it's like loud. Here, it's like you're inside the bell of Big Ben. It's going... dun, 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 and someone's asking you, why? Why?
So, Humphrey, how did you get 979?
Well, 225 times 8.
225 times 8, sure.
75. 75 times 8.
OK, 75 times 8. What is that supposed to be?
That is... many...
600.
Yeah, 600, of course. plus 50.
Plus 50,
plus 50. Is 650, as we all know.
Yeah.
and then you minus... No, you, then times by... No.
Give me a second here.
Add eight times nine.
Eight times nine is 72.
Sure. Of course it is. And then you have to add VAT.
So we've got 866.
OK, we're getting super
that's
close.
Basically 979.
OK, John, how did you get 980, which is now looking like our best hope?
I think, well, 75 plus 50 is 125.
75 plus 50 is 125.
Times by 8.
Times by 8 is 1,000.
And then take off the 9, the 3 and the 8.
9, 3 and the other 8 for 980. Well done.
OK, so 7 points to you, John. Rachel, could they have done it?
If you say 9 times 8 is 72,
yep.
Add the 50
as I
is
said.
122,
yes.
Times that by 8 for 976, and add on the 3.
OK, it's time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Rich, what have you got for us?
What?
What have you got for us there, Rich, in Dictionary Corner for us?
I have a dictionary. am I supposed to have something?
Well, no. Traditionally on the show, at this point, I would go over to Dictionary Corner and you would have an amusing anecdote or a story, a song, a poem. Do you have anything you could do or say?
Well, Jimmy, I'm glad you asked. Wrote this song. I think all songs should be about heartbreak and emotion. I'm a big Scrabble fan. Sometimes if your girlfriend or your wife is cheating on you, it's very hard to tell. But she might be laying down some subtle clues when you're playing Scrabble. Could have played heart. The word was right there from the start, but you rearranged the letters. And it came out hater. Could have played chaste. But you let my good love go to waste. Put your tits in someone else's face. Why do you play cheats? Could have gave me roses, but you just gave me sores. Put down shower, but you stay gone for hours, so I think I'll play whores. Could have played love, but you played EVOL. Who the fuck taught you to spell? Evil just as well. You could have played bedroom, please, but you played boredom and asleep. I don't need these acrimonies. So I'm moving to Micronesia.
Scores at the moment, Sean and Humphrey have 5 points, John and Sarah in the lead with 12. And here's your teaser. The words are gonad tip and the clue is one way to become a parent. That's gonad tip, one way to become a parent. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were gonad tip and the clue was one way to become a parent. It was, of course, adopting. OK, they've been playing in team so far, but this letters round is just for Sean and Sarah. So, Sean...
Yes!
Feeling confident, Sean? OK, Sean and Sarah, just you two on this one.
I'm not even going to use my eyes.
It's really harsh.
Sean, you're to pick the letters.
Ooh, well, I'll start with a vowel, please.
Thank you, Sean. I.
Oh, yeah, and another one, please.
A.
And another one.
E.
OK, and some consonants, please.
N.
Keep coming.
S.
And another.
H.
And another.
You can get high Sean out of that. Out of interest.
And a vowel.
I.
Oh, shit. And a consonant.
And the last one. M.
OK, let's count down.
Rachel.
It's a strong hand. What did you get, Sarah?
I've got a definite five and a wobbly six.
What are you going to go for, the definite five or the wobbly six?
Wobbly six.
Wobbly six it is. OK. Sean, what you got?
I've got a six.
Confident six. OK, what's your six?
Shapes.
Oh, no. No, it's a wobbly six. It's a wobbly six. Confident five.
Okay, Sarah, what was yours?
Mannish.
Mannish, like John. Susie, could I have mannish?
You need two N's,
that's
Sarah.
What I thought. That's why it was wobbly.
So no points there at all for anyone. Could they have done any better, Dictionary Corner?
Yeah, I had seven. In shape. How are you feeling? I'm in shape. Impish, mishap.
Excellent.
Impish and mishap.
Sixes.
That means the scores are still... Sean and Humphrey have five, John and Sarah have 12. Right, time now for John and Humphrey to go head-to-head. This numbers round is just for them. OK, John, you're to pick the numbers.
Well, since it's Humphrey playing against me, we'll have one big one and the rest sort of embarrassingly small.
And they are 10.
Is 10 the big one?
No. Three, ooh. Five, wait for it. Seven, and the big one, 75. And the target, 812.
The time starts now. OK, John, what you got?
I've got 813.
OK, pretty close. Humphrey, what do you got?
I've got 807.
Okay. 813. John, how did you do?
75 plus 5.
75 plus 5, 80.
Plus 7 over 7.
Plus 7 over 7 for 81.
Oh, piss flaps, I just said.
What's 7 over 7? What does that mean?
That's 1, mate.
I didn't know you could do that.
Times by 10.
Times by 10 for 8.
Hey, we're learning maths as well. This is fun.
Another 3.
Another 3, 813. One away.
Rachel, could it be done?
Well, I think... Do you have it, John? Do you want to do it for pride's sake?
Should I stop to 75 plus 5? No.
No,
you carry on with it, mate. I don't want to make you look silly.
Yeah, you could have said 75 plus 7 is 82, times by 10 is 820, and then 5 plus 3 is 8, take away 812.
Well, you should have done. You should have done that. That's what you should have done.
If only I'd been playing.
If you'd been playing, you would have done that, right? John.
I think I'm tired.
Okay, John's crying.
Let's do a numbers round quick. I've got a chance.
What happened? Did he go down the wrong way?
It's just a tickle and it won't go away.
Take a moment.
Ironically, there. Oh, I thought there was a hole behind that.
Do you want to use that?
I've got tissues.
Do you need to get Heimlich? I'll Heimlich you, John.
Nothing down there.
Come on.
I think if you try and Heimlich me, you'll strangle me because you're about 10 times taller than I am.
Do you want me to do it?
There's nothing to Heimlich. I'm not trying to pee.
I'm not doing anything. Is anybody?
Look at the size of him.
Come on.
Yeah, just come on.
Sort of created a blockage in two places now.
Hi.
Oh, sure.
So you'll notice I was always coughing into the hand, never onto the food.
OK, the scores at the moment, Humphrey and Sean have 5 points, John and Sarah have 19.
All right.
And here's your teaser. The words are nose fart and the clue is where you get a fresh breeze. It's nose fart where you get a fresh breeze. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were nose fart, and the clue was where you get a fresh breeze. It was, of course, seafront. OK, well, we're halfway through the game, so good a time as any to bring out Rachel's glamorous assistant. Please welcome Joe Wilkinson. Joe, why are you dressed as Santa?
I'll be honest with you, Jimmy, I completely muddled up the months. I'll be honest with you, I thought it was March. I've actually got everyone some presents. I've got everyone some skirting board, if you want a heart helper. And I've got Rachel something as well, because, you know, she's my boss and that. I've done you a painting. Look, me on a horse.
Are you a eunuch?
My eunuch? No, there's my penis. And I thought that could go in your hallway.
Brilliant,
next to
all the other ones.
Yeah, yeah.
Lovely.
I'll put it here for now.
Thanks.
Merry Christmas!
Joe, sorry, your microphone's just fallen down there.
No, that's deliberate. wait until someone helps. Oh, that's it, there. Actually, just clip it onto something rather than wedge it in.
So you're Rachel's assistant. Yep. How's the job been going since we last saw you?
Oh, it's been good. Got more responsibilities now. Still have to empty the bins and bathe her, but I also now have to look after racing pigeons.
Right. Rachel's got racing pigeons?
Yeah, about 200. She keeps it in a spare room. It fucking stinks, but what are you going
to
do? Let's play countdown! It's my new catchphrase. I shout it randomly.
Okay, back to the game. John, your turn to choose the letters.
Hello, Rachel.
Hey, John.
Hi, Santa. Can I have a consonant, please?
Oh, yeah, I should point out I've added a few characters.
Okay.
I've got like, an exclamation mark there. If you want it loud. brackets.
I did warn you about using your initiative.
I'm not listening to you. Comma, if you want it there. Don't know what that is, it's internet-y. And that, I think that's just an I.
Okay. John letters.
I think I'd still like a consonant.
Consonant?
You're a grumpy bugger.
And another one, please.
W.
Ah, the Northwest.
Really? You've been outside.
And a vowel, please.
Ooh. That's me.
Hope it's an A.
There's no bloody A's. It has to be a. There's now.
You're not supposed to tell them.
Oh, yeah.
His own.
Own.
One.
It's a bit of a free for all now, isn't it?
This is a piece of piss.
We just. I'll have another consonant.
F.
Oh.
Can I tempt you with a vowel?
Yeah. I'll straighten them out.
Quite like this. Who wants it most?
Me!
Alright.
You!
Let's have a consonant, yeah.
Oh, you twat.
And then another one.
T.
And then why don't you slap as a last vowel up there?
Oh, that's
why don't you share this one?
You're getting too excited. A. There we go.
Okay, let's hear that countdown clock. John, what have you got?
I got a funny four.
A funny four?
Yeah.
Okay, Sarah, what have you got?
I've got a five.
Humphrey, what have you got?
I've got a definite five.
Sean. Sean. Sean! Sean, tap him for me. Tap him.
Sean.
Jimmy, Sean. I knew exactly what I was doing there.
So I've got a five.
John, let's hear your four.
Fart.
Did you see a fart up there?
Now fart. Now you fart.
Okay, Sarah, what have you got?
Frown.
And Humphrey?
Water.
Okay, and Sean, what have you got?
Frown.
5 points each. what could they have had?
Fortune.
Fortune was out there, was it?
I got a fortune cookie.
Okay, the scores at the moment, Humphrey and Sean have 10, and John and Sarah have 24. OK, I'm talking about numbers round. Sean and Humphrey, your turn to pick.
One from the top and the little ones.
One large, five little ones. 10. 6. 7. 3. 2. Move the belly. Move the belly. Move the belly. I'm 50. And now I go.
I'll do the button. I'll do the button. Oh, that's my lucky number.
OK, so your target is 996. Your time starts now. Sean, what have you got?
996.
Humphrey, what have you got?
1,030.
Do your parents ever ask for a refund from eating?
Sarah, what have you got?
994.
994, OK. And John, what have you got?
I've got 996.
Terrific skills. OK, Sean, how did you get 996?
Well, you go 2 times 50 is 100, times 10 is 1,000, 7 minus 3 is 4, take that away, and you've got 996.
I do it the same way, and then I listen in there, and there's just you can just hear a woman screaming.
It's amazing that you can work with that.
Nothing.
You don't hear it?
No.
You just drowned it out.
Yeah, I've learned to do that.
Wow. Okay, so 10 points each. The scores at the moment, Humphrey and Sean have 20 points, John and Sarah out in the lead with 34. And here's your final teaser. The words are last anus and the clue is taste fruity. That's last anus, taste fruity. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were last anus and the clue was taste fruity. It was, of course, sultanas. OK, time for another letters game. Sean and Humphrey, your turn to choose.
All right. May I have a consonant, please?
I'll start with the consonants.
Can you do it? I've just got to wrap my mum's present up. I've got her a manhole cover. She's very difficult to buy for.
Did you steal that?
Lifted off the pavement there.
I'm not sure then you're meant to take them.
No one said I couldn't.
He's right, you know.
When you leave here, M.
Vowel, please.
E.
Consonant, please.
P.
Vowel, please.
A.
Consonant, please.
Joe, R. No scissors in your mouth. We've discussed this.
Vowel, please.
Do what I want, mate.
I.
Consonant, please.
S.
Another consonant, please.
B.
Another consonant, please.
And the last one, T.
OK, the clock starts now. What have you got? Sarah?
I've got 5.
5. OK, John?
I've got an 8.
Ooh.
Correct. Humphrey, what have you got?
I've only got a 5.
It's OK. Good for you. Sean, what have you got?
I've got 6.
6. OK, Humphrey, what's your 5?
It is prism.
Prism. OK. Sean, what's your 6?
Impart. Impart.
Impart, OK. Sarah?
Prize.
As in prize apart.
Open, yeah.
Yes, very good.
Great.
Yeah, like that.
OK. They didn't need a lot of prizing. John?
Balmiest.
What, sorry?
Balmiest, as in Barmy Army.
Fantastic. It's in the dictionary. Well done.
Susie, could they have done any better?
Primates, but that would have done any better, no.
OK, we're now going to our final numbers round. OK, John and Sarah, your turn to pick the numbers.
Can I have two big ones and the rest small, please?
You can.
I'll do one.
OK, I'll do the other three. Do you want to put it up?
Yep. That's how many times I've fallen down a well. I walk about in the dark near a well a lot.
Is that where you get nosebleeds?
Yep, nosebleeds. Get a lot of nosebleeds as well.
OK, 4, 2, 10 and 4. And the large 2, 75 and 25. And the target, 762.
Time starts now.
It is.
Okay, Humphrey, straight to you. What have
Why?
You got?
Why? Why did you always come to me first? Is it because I'm bad? Well, fine, I got 769, so fuck off. Through fucking earphones here, we go, God, this is an easy one. This is easy, I've done it already.
It's made me feel more of a twat. Sean's got a lot better at this game over the last couple of weeks, it would appear.
Oh, no, I haven't.
Let's see how you do. Sarah, how have you done?
Oh, not good. 780, not good.
780, not good. Okay, go on, here. Go on. You, John?
You?
You, John.
Oi, Cardigan, what have you got? 762, mate.
OK.
I might not be popular, but I got it.
Sean, did you get it?
Yeah. I did it by just willpower. I used maths. I used the force of the mind. 10 times 75, which is 750.
Yeah, right? You're still in the game.
And then by using sheer willpower, I used the 10 again. By imposing my will on math.
OK, John, how did you do it?
You do that, and then 4 times 2 is 8.
Oh, I don't times, mate.
OK, no, I'll take over.
No, I'm not doing it, mate.
It's this one. But you did it there.
Oh, I thought, yeah, I did. Fucking times!
And then add the other 4.
Add the other 4. 12, 10, 16.
Well, 10 points to John. Where's the 25?
You don't have to use all of them.
What? I tell you, the scores going into today's Countdown Conundrum are Sean and Humphrey have a very creditable 20, John and Sarah have 52, so it's all still to play for. It's not really all still to play for. They've won by some considerable margin. But as a formality, why don't we try and give this a go? OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Humphrey, have you got it?
Yeah.
Go on, what have you got?
Is it ambulance?
Is it ambulance? Yeah. Let's have a look. Yeah. At the final moment, at the 11th hour, Humphrey Carr has redeemed himself on Countdown by getting an ambulance. OK, so the final scores are Humphrey and Sean have 30 points. John and Sarah are the winners with 52. That's it from us. Good night.
Now, if you ever miss the fun of The Last Leg, 4OD is your friend. You can find episodes there to watch at your leisure. Well, it's just time for a quick brush up and change of clobber for Sarah Millican, and then she's all on her own. Chatterbox Live, next.